use incognito mode just in case.
Bro?
What's up, bro?
I'm creating a masterpiece?
So I was just now booking my flights to go to Europe. I remember a while ago I said that I'd be making a video on the things that I do to save money when traveling, and I ended up not really ever making that video, so let's make that video now. So the flights are generally what throw most people off from actually traveling. I'm only gonna get into the actual booking of the flight because I think that it's the hardest to control in terms of like prices. I think that once you land at your destination, if you're careful with where you eat, where you stay and all that stuff, you can find ways of making everything more affordable. Through personal experience, I found a few things that definitely work for me and that I do it every single time before I book a flight. All right, so the first thing that I do happens before I even try to book the flight, which is opening up incognito mode. Some of you are probably already familiar with incognito mode for a variety of different reasons. Basically, incognito mode is a very good way of preventing that platform from tracking your cookies and history. So I'm sure that a lot of you have experience where you look for a flight, you find a kind of good deal, but you don't really book it. Then you look at it the next day and the prices have just gone up. Some websites claim that they don't raise the price on you, but if you want to play it safe, use incognito mode just in case.
Bro?
What's up, bro?
Get into the shot real quick. Get into the shot. Give me your number one, give me your number one tip to travel cheaper. Quick, now!
Look. look.
Anyways, let's get back to what we were talking. I lost my train of thought now. What are you even doing here?
Okay.
You need to transfer files. Bye bye. Okay.
Arrivederci, Roma.
So whenever I book a flight, I always search for everything through incognito mode. The website basically thinks that you're searching for that search the first time. Didn't really phrase that correctly, but I think that you guys get the idea. Major key alert. All right, another thing is layovers. If I'm not in a rush to get to my destination, I almost always book layovers. If I'm flying from Spain to Finland, I try to find a flight that passes by London. If I'm flying from Spain to Dubai, I try to find a flight that stops by Turkey. You get to your destination for cheaper, and you get to visit an extra city for free. It's like a two-for-one kind of deal. Layovers tend to be cheaper than direct flights, honestly, because they're just a pain in the ass. Normally, they ask for you to stay like 7 hours in the airport, and it's just a waste of time. Nobody wants that kind of flight. But if you exaggerate the layover, where you're open to staying, let's say 54, 55, 60 hours in the airport, you can leave the airport, go explore around whatever city you're in, and then just come back in a few days and get to your destination. It's cheaper, it encourages adventuring and traveling, you'll experience more cities in general, and you'll get to your destination anyways.
Another one.
Okay, the third kind of recommendation that I have, I think is more obvious than the rest, basically just to keep an eye out for social media offers. Lately, I've been seeing a lot more good deals on social media. Like, nobody likes to get spammed. Nobody likes to, you know, all these kind of marketing campaigns that you see on Facebook. It's a waste of time, but you can find some really good ones. Just recently, I started really kind of looking more on social media, and you really do find good deals. I found a round trip from Spain to the UK for $10, round trip from Spain to Italy for $10. And when you go to book it, you know, I was expecting some sort of like hidden fee, but it was actually $10. I couldn't believe it. So obviously keep an eye out, don't obsess about it. But if you are scrolling and you see something that looks pretty good, look into it. It might actually be a very good deal.
And another one.
Now, another thing that I personally do is use a particular website called Momondo. And I promise you that this video is not sponsored in any way. I have no kind of interest in helping this business at all. But I do have to say that they have better deals than I have seen anywhere else. And what they have that I think is really good is basically when you search for something, they lay out like a little bar graph at the top that shows you the most expensive days and the cheapest days of the month. 90% of the time, they'll have cheaper offers than everything else that I search for. As I said, this is a personal preference. It's what I do whenever I search for other flights.
And another one.
So lastly, I guess you can call this somewhat like of a bonus tip. It's kind of hard to prove, but there's this general myth that if you depart on Wednesday, your flights will be cheaper. And it makes a lot of sense. Friday, Saturday, and Sunday tend to be super expensive because it's weekend. And Wednesday is just kind of right in the middle of the the week. From my personal experience, I've always seen that Tuesdays and Wednesdays do tend to be cheaper. Once again, it is kind of hard to prove, but I do tend to do that. So in conclusion, overall, incognito mode, momondo.fi, depart on Wednesdays, layovers, and social media offers. If you guys have any questions or further recommendations, leave it in the comment section below, and I'll see you guys next time.